The preparation of the UPSC exam is a very long process because the examination itself lasts for more than 1 year, and you on a conservative side also will have to start at least 6 months in advance. That means presumably the entire preparation process is going to last for almost 18 months. Now, one of the major challenges of the preparation of this exam is distractions. Now, it is very easy to say, it is very easy to tell that, you know, if you are a UPSC aspirant, if you are serious, if you are aiming the exam properly, then you should not be distracted, you should be focused and all. But nobody tells you how actually to be focused. Because, you know, please understand this one thing, that maintaining your focus for a week, for a month is very easy. Like we all used to do in our board exams or, you know, in our college exams, when we used to study for a month or for a week, and we used to totally focus. I remember in my college when I was doing my graduation from IIT Kanpur, we used to study for 3-4 days only before the exams. And for those 3-4 days, we only used to study. Nobody even used to sleep, and we used to shift to the library for 24 hours, and we used to be totally focused. But we were able to do that because that process was only for 3-4 days. If somebody would ask me that, can you retain that kind of focus for an year and a half, the answer is going to be an astounding no. So the idea is to avoid distractions, and we have to understand that we generally, the people who prepare for this exam are young people, and young people get a number of other distractions as well that we will talk about. Now, we have to take care of those distractions in a structured manner so that, you know, whatever we do, it should sustain for an year and a half. It is not going to help that for a month if you are totally focused and then you totally fizzle out, right? So we have to take care of a number of distractions in a specific manner, in a decent manner. Now, what are the major distractions? Let's try to list down a few distractions. Some major ones which are there in front of us. We'll be very open about this. First, in my opinion, now your opinion may vary from mine, but in my opinion, the first distraction is social media. The first distraction is social media. The second distraction is friends. The third distractions are romantic relationships. The fourth distraction is other career avenues. Right. So we'll discuss in a nutshell these four distractions and how we can probably try to ensure that we don't that these distractions do not affect our preparation. Coming first to the social media. Now, what is social media? I don't need to tell you. We all are on social media, and we all, trust me, waste a significant amount of time on social media. So my advice in social media, just take one word of advice from me. Take one word of advice. It is going to be slightly difficult in the beginning, but trust me, it is not going to affect your life in any manner. Delete Facebook. I know I'm asking you to take a harsh measure or whatever. Many of you spend a lot of time on Facebook and all that and believe that it is giving you a lot of knowledge. Trust me, Facebook is not giving you any knowledge that is worth studying. So on social media, the problem is, you know, the idea is to be very, very strict. And that strictness will not come unless, you know, as long as you are there. At least from your cell phones. At least from your cell phones, totally delete it. Totally delete any kind of social media app from your cell phone. Absolutely. I mean, there should be no two ways about it. Now, why? Because, you know, I'm sure it must have happened with many of you that you logged into Facebook and you just took a 5 minutes break, that I will take a 5 minute break and I'll just see Facebook and come back to my books once again. And all of a sudden, you might have ended up, you know, probably 1 hour later, you would realize that, oh, what the hell am I doing on Facebook even now? Who's this person whom I don't even know, whose profile I'm checking out, whose images I'm looking at? Trust me, it is not worth it. These social media applications are structured in such a manner that they will take you from one profile to another, then to another, then to another, and there will be absolutely no sense of timing that you will have. So, in order to manage social media, the best way is to delete it. You know, trust me on that, you have to delete it. If you don't delete it, in that case, what you should do is, you should fixate an hour, right, or probably 30 minutes of your time every day to ensure that you are able to, spend time on social media. But trust me, that is not going to work. That is not going to happen because many of the aspirants stay alone. So in that case, the time spent on social media is going to be many folds. Don't do that, right? So that is very, very clear that, you should be very strict, be it Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever else people follow these days, Snapchat, I don't know what else is there. Delete all of them. You don't need them. Sometimes people say that we get a lot of news from Facebook. But trust me, on Facebook as well, half the news that comes is fake news, is wrong. It is not verified, not verifiable. And even these days in Facebook, there are very hardened opinions. People are either pro-government or anti-government. Useless, mindless debates are going on. That is not helping any civil services aspirant. So don't go into that conundrum. Even if you stay on Facebook, do not become a Facebook warrior. Second advice is, do not become a Facebook warrior. Do you guys understand what a Facebook warrior is? A person who argues with others on Facebook. Do not become that person. Do not comment. Do not argue with people that whether Modi is right or Kejriwal is right or Congress is right. Do not do all that. Because that is not going to help you. That is going to anger you in certain way. That is going to kind of trouble you mentally in a certain way. Do not indulge in that. My word of advice will be, delete it, get rid of it. Rather, read a newspaper, read a magazine, read a well-researched piece. Talk to people in physical. I mean, that will be a better idea. Get rid of social media. That is the first thing. And trust me on that. If you follow my advice today, you are going to thank me. At least, an year and a half later, when you crack your exam, you are going to thank me because the contribution of this is going to be immense. Second thing is friends. Now, many of you will say that friends are absolutely necessary, and I totally agree. It is absolutely necessary to have a good bunch of friends, to have a great deal of friends, to be interacting with them, to be talking with them. But when I say friends, you should understand that your friends cannot contribute. Their contribution to your academics is zero. Their contribution to academics is zero. This is one thing you should realize. So you should meet your friends. I'm not discouraging you. In fact, I'm the person, I'm a teacher. I always tell my students that go watch movies. I mean, come on, enjoy a little because it's a 1.5 year long preparation. You cannot be like a robot, just, imprisoned in your houses and, having a very troublesome life. No, have fun, relax. But be very mindful that you should meet your friends or you should spend time your friends for fun, for entertainment. Many of the, why I wrote friends here is that many of the people have discussions. Many times people meet friends and they end up having discussions for the whole day. Trust me, I have seen people who keep discussing the national and international events or whatever for the entire day. And they believe that these discussions are academic discussions. They believe that these discussions are academic and these discussions are contributing to my knowledge. Trust me, there can be nothing worse for your preparation than spending an entire day discussing or spending 3, 4, 5 hours discussing random things with your friends. That way, the time which you could have spent enjoying or refreshing yourself, that time also you are struggling and you are indulgent into something academic and you are not even learning much. Because trust me, half the arguments which your friends are making, they might not be useful. So I have seen many people wasting days, weeks, months into these so-called UPSC discussions, which are absolutely meaningless, which are just a pretentious measure to show off each other's knowledge of facts, which is absolutely irrelevant for UPSC. So if you have to discuss as a policy, make it a policy. If you have to discuss something with somebody, discuss it with somebody who knows more than you, right? If you have to discuss something, discuss it with a teacher. Discuss it with a mentor. Discuss it with a person who has more knowledge than you. Why are you discussing it with your peers? Because your peers do not know more than you. In that case, their value, the value addition you are going to have from that discussion is minimal. So meet your friends, go out with them, but restrict these meetings to probably an hour or 2 hours and count this time as the fun time. Whenever you are meeting your friends, count this time as your fun time, because it is going to be fun time. Have fun with your friends. I mean, talk about movies. Go watch movies. Go for walks. Play a game. Play a sport. Do good things with your friends, right? Do not discuss UPSC, because that discussion is not useful. The time, the idea of the time with your friends is supposed to be the time when you unwind. The time when you, kind of, ease yourself up. Right? So that should be the idea of time spent with the friends. Coming to the third one, the most complicated and the most delicate one of romantic relationships. Now, normally people do not discuss this aspect, but it is a very clearly biological aspect that, most of the aspirants are from the age range of 21 to 30, 32 or something like that. And that is the age when you, need attention of a romantic partner. When you get into romantic relationships, very good. There is no problem with that. I have seen many people, finding, or meeting somebody during their preparation era, getting married to them, having a great successful life, both of them getting selected, becoming IAS officers, great, great lives as well. But I have also seen people wasting, the entire days, entire attempts, just wandering with the boyfriend or the girlfriend. So now that is something, in which I can give you both kind of examples. So it is something for you to decide that where are you falling, right? So the point is, my advice in general is that if you have an existing relationship, right, if you are a girl and you have an existing boyfriend, or if you are a boy, you have an existing girlfriend. Existing means which is prior to your starting the preparation, right? So which is prior to, let's say, you had a college girlfriend or a college boyfriend, and after college you are preparing for UPSC. In that case, continue with that relationship, because what happens, it provides you with some kind of an emotional stability, which is a great thing. Because what happens at that age, if you do not have any romantic relationship or any romantic inclinations, then that becomes troublesome, that troubles you, that creates anxiety, right? And but if you are dating somebody, if you have a steady relationship going on, that calms you, that relaxes you. You also have some kind of a person to go to, for physical comfort, for intellectual and emotional comfort as well. That's a great idea. That's a great idea. But if you are not in a relationship, let me tell this to you very, very bluntly and clearly. Do not start a new relationship while in preparation. Do not start a new relationship when you are preparing. Do not, please, please, please do not make this mistake. Right? If you start a new relationship while you are preparing, then I'm sure many of you must have been in some relationships. I have also been in, a few. We all know that in the beginning, you are very anxious all the time, right? I mean, you are always thinking about the romantic partner. You are always writing to that person, always chatting to that person, always calling that person, always thinking of that person. That is a luxury you cannot afford. If you are serious for UPSC exam, that is a luxury you cannot afford, unfortunately. So even if you find somebody you are interested in, right? Even if you find somebody that you think, okay, this person could be an interesting person to date or something, Start meeting that person, that's okay. You know, start spending some time with that person, be friends with that person, but do not start a romantic relationship while you are in the middle of the preparation. If that person had, if you had a prior existing relationship, it's fine. In that case also, let's say if you are preparing and if you have a girlfriend, then I think it's a great idea that you sit down with her, have a talk with her, and tell her that you are doing this for your future. And in that case, probably for the next 1 year or so, you will not be able to meet her that much. You will not be able to probably talk for the entire day with her. And same goes with boyfriends. I mean, if you're a girl and if you have a boyfriend. So the same thing goes. But have a discussion. Have a nice, healthy discussion that it's a futuristic step I'm taking. And in order to be successful in that, it is very much required. I'm sure anybody will understand. But do not start a new relationship, because that is going to be extremely detrimental for your academic health. Let me tell you right now. Fourth is one major distraction which I have seen many students or many aspirants actually, wandering into. That is when they are preparing. Or let's say generally it happens when you have given one attempt and you are generally in your second attempt. Then I have seen many people doing all this. So what happens is you have given one attempt, you didn't get through. Probably you gave mains or interview or you didn't qualify prelims. Something happened. You didn't qualify. Now, you believe that I should start earning something as well. Right? So it is not a bad thing per se. It is not a very bad thing. But the point is that it should not become the primary aim of your life. So I have seen many people that they start teaching in some coaching institute, or they start correcting answer books in some coaching institute, believing that this will help me with my preparation as well. That does not happen. Trust me. So if you are preparing seriously, avoid, you might get some 5-10,000 rupees every month by doing this, but think of the aim you are having in life. I mean, of course, if you need money to survive, then do it. I mean, then if you need money, then you need money. You'll have to take some classes or something. But if you do not need money, then my advice will be, do not indulge in these things, right? Because they distract you in a big manner. So if you are preparing for UPSC, you should rather, stay focused in your preparation only, rather than looking for some part-time jobs or some, teaching avenues or something. Do not do that. That does not really help you a lot. So these were the four major distractions I wanted to talk about. Hopefully what I had discussed might be of some help for you. And if you want any further discussion, if you want any further assistance or help or guidance in these matters, please comment and we will get back to you.